Hey guys, this is Asmita. Today I'm going to show you how to do the top coat for the coasters that have already come out of the molds. So I have these two sets of coasters here, and I have my countertop epoxy, which is high heat resistant epoxy. So I've put my coasters on a leveled surface, and now I'm taking my wet wipes, and what I'm going to do here is I'm with this wipe going to just wipe off the top of all of my coasters that I want to top coat. I'm doing this to make sure there are no dust particles or any other debris from the atmosphere, so that when I do my top coat, it comes out as a transparent and clean layer. I always emphasize on the importance of doing top coats on your coasters and other artworks, because it does make a difference. So I have almost 3 ounces of my epoxy here, and I'm going to now pour little by little over all my coasters, and then I'll show you how we spread this. And the next step, so the temperature, the ideal temperature for this epoxy to be used is 70 to 75 degrees. That is the room temperature that they ask for. And if by chance you are not maintaining the room temperature, you have to be really fast, because then it starts to cure quickly. So what I'm going to do now here is I have my silicone spatula here, which I use for my painting as well. With this, I am slowly going to just spread the epoxy towards the edges. So what this is going to do, this will give a heat resistant coat as well as a final top coat to my artworks. The epoxy that I used for making these coasters was not heat resistant up to 500 degrees Fahrenheit, so I thought, why not to just make another coat of the high heat resistant ones so that these become long lasting. Usually I make my coasters with a very high heat resistant epoxy, but these ones were just an experiment, so I just used whatever was available on my work surface without thinking too much. But the way they turned out, I thought I would love to keep them. So this way, as you can see, I'm not letting any of my epoxy to fall on the sides. I am just putting enough epoxy to cover the edges. That's it. I'll show you another way how you can do the top coat while your coasters are already inside the molds. I've done a couple on my Instagram already, wherein we had a couple of blue coaster sets, and I taught how to coat those when those are out of the mold, or the other way as well, when they are already in the mold and we decide to just give them another coating. So for these ones, these are already made up of countertop epoxy, and we did these in our live session yesterday. So I thought, why not to now give them another coat, because I love the way these turned out. whole process of making these ones is on my IGTV as well. So if you're not following me on Instagram, please do that. And I'm doing these live sessions every day on my Instagram to support my latest initiative, Art for Mental Health and Therapy, wherein I'm giving out free tutorials every day to all those who want to learn different styles, different mediums of art. So please join me during those sessions. I also try to sometimes save those sessions in my IGTV so that those who miss those can come back and watch. So the whole process is about different artworks that we created during these live sessions are mostly either on my YouTube channel or on my Instagram, and I'll put the descriptions in my put the details in my description box, as well as there are description there are details about these in my bio, so do check that. If you have any questions or concerns, or if you're stuck anywhere in your artwork, you can straight away DM me on Instagram, where I'm active most of the times, and I try to get back to everybody as much as I can, as soon as I can. And if you want to collab, do send me a DM as well. If you are a small shop and you would like to support this initiative, wherein I am giving hours of free live tutorials without charging any money from anybody, if you would like to support that with your products or something like that, then also let me know. I would love to hear and collab with you. So while we are talking, I have covered all the 8 coasters with my countertop epoxy, and it's already getting thicker. So what I'm going to be doing now is I have these ones which are still in the mold. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just straight away pour the epoxy into these molds. So as you can see, there is some resin already on the coaster because I didn't clean these ones, I didn't wipe these again, so I took that out, and now I am only going to be spreading this towards the edges again. Since I didn't take them out, so there is no way that the epoxy will go under the layer that is already cured, so you don't have to worry much about these ones. And now with the help of my spatula, I am spreading on this one towards the edges, and we are almost done with spreading the epoxy. Now I'll tell you what the next step is. So these are my floral ones, that's my autumn one, and those are the baby pink. So I have some epoxy left over here. What I do is I always keep some molds around me, and I keep on dumping all this leftover epoxy into those molds. So I am just scraping as much as I can from this cup, and I'm gonna be putting this on to the next one here, and I'm also going to put the cup upside down so that if there is anything, any residue inside the cup, that will just fall into that mold. Right. So these are really fun things to do during this time, because the weather is okay. It's not very hot, not very cold, and these really make great crafts. So now I'm taking my heat gun and going ahead and trying to dissipate the bubbles. Okay, so with this epoxy, you have to be really careful that you do not leave any residue of bubbles, otherwise that would just trap inside the molds. So now what I'm going to do is I'm taking these one by one and looking at where I see some bubbles so that I can go ahead and either pop them with the help of a tool like this, or maybe a toothpick or something, or I can go ahead and go once more over these with my heat gun. So I'm just checking them as to what is happening here. Sometimes there are these small bits that are due to unleveled surface, or due to your surface not being clean enough. So for that I have this tool that makes sure that my surface is level. So what I do is I just put it on my table and I see if my surface is leveled. Then I go one by one over my artworks and check that again. So right now what I'm doing is I am making sure that the epoxy is touching all the sides, so that the sides are not left untouched. These really look great when they cure, because when we do a top coat like this, it really adds a shiny layer which is transparent, and it creates a different kind of effect. So I really love to do this extra step with my coasters, and I always suggest everybody to do that as well. We are almost done here. I'll go ahead just once more with my heat gun over the coasters that I'm touching like this, so as to make the epoxy leveled once more. But since the epoxy is self-leveling, so you do not have to worry too much about that. But I like to get the flawless finish by just investing a little more time for this extra step that I'm doing with you guys today. Okay, so with my heat gun, I'm going ahead once more, and now on high heat. Okay, so the coasters are looking fine to me. Now I am going to just cover them in a way that no dust particles are there in the environment where they are going to be curing for next 24 hours. And once I'm done with that, I'll be showing you the final outcome on my Instagram, which is asmeezart_by_asmeeta. So stay tuned guys and follow me for more action. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.